The Environment Protection Act. Overview. The Environment Protection Act 1986 not only has important constitutional implications but also an international background. The spirit of the proclamation adopted by the United Nations Conference on Human Environment, which took place in Stockholm in June 1972, was implemented by the Government of India by creating this act. Although there were several existing laws that dealt directly or indirectly with environmental issues, it was necessary to have a general legislation for environmental protection because the existing laws focused on very specific type of pollution or specific categories of hazards, substances or were indirectly related to the environment. Through laws that control land use, protect our national parks and sanctuaries and our wildlife. However, there were no overarching legislation and certain areas of environmental hazards were not covered. There were also gaps in areas that were potential environmental hazards. And there were several inadequate linkages in handling matters of industrial and environmental safety. This was essentially related to the multiplicity of regulatory agencies, thus there was a need for an authority which could assume the lead role for studying, planning, and implementing long-term requirements of environmental safety and give directions to as well as coordinate a safety of speedy and adequate response to emergency situations threatening to the environment. The Act was thus passed to protect the environment, as there was a growing concern over the deteriorating state of the environment. As impacts grow considerably, environmental protection became a national priority in the 1970s. The decline in the environmental quality was evidenced by increasing pollution, loss of forest cover, and an increasing threat to biodiversity. The presence of excessive concentrations of harmful chemicals in the atmosphere. An aquatic ecosystem leads to the disruption of food chains and a loss of species. These are symptoms of a rapidly deteriorating environment. The growing risk of environmental accidents and threat to life support systems now looms threateningly over our civilization. The decision taken at the conference in Stockholm strongly voiced these environmental concerns, and several measures were made possible for environmental protection. While the need for a wider general legislation to protect our environment is now in place, it has become increasingly evident that our environmental situation continues to deteriorate. We need to implement this act much more aggressively if our environment is to be protected. Public concern and support is crucial for implementing the EPA. This must be supported by an enlightened media, good administrators, highly aware policy makers, informed judiciary, and trained technocrats who together can influence and prevent further degradation of our environment. Each of us has a responsibility to make this happen. Salient features of the Environmental Protection Act 1986. The most prominent features of the Act are commemorated as follows. Under this Act, the central government is empowered to take request measures to protect and improve the environment, coordinate the acts of state governments, authorities and officers, plan as well as execute national programs on the prevention, management and abatement of environmental pollution. Establish quality standards of environment, including standards for discharge of pollutants. Restrict areas where industries or their processes can or cannot be carried out. Establish procedures and safeguards to prevent accidents conducive to environmental pollution. Establish safeguards for the management of hazardous substances. Examine processes, substances and materials liable to cause environmental pollution. Encourage and sponsor research and innovation that relates to environmental problems. Inspect premises, plants or machinery and direct officers or authorities to take request. Measures to prevent, control and abat environmental pollution. It bars the discharge and emission of any environmental pollution beyond the standard limits by any person carrying industrial operations. Strict penalties have been prescribed for transgressing any provisions of this Act. Under the Act, the person is charged of a place is obligated to inform the appropriate authorities of any accidental discharge of pollutants exceeding the specific limits. Once informed, these authorities will take request remedial steps to mitigate the pollution cost and the expenses for the same would be recoverable from the polluter subject to interest. The officers empowered by the central government can take samples of air, water, soil, any other substance from any factory or premises for analysis. This Act provides for the establishment of environmental laboratories that work to protect the environment and people from contamination. The jurisdiction of civil courts have been buried under this Act. Objectives and purposes of Environment Protection Act 1986. First, the main objective of this Act is to provide for the protection and improvement of the environment and all matter connected with it. Second, most importantly, it aims to implement the decision reached at the UN Conference on Human Environment, which was held in Stockholm in June 1972, of which India had also been a participant. Three, the previous environment-related laws were all very specific, and due to the same, they left certain gaps. This Act serves the purpose of covering all those gaps left behind by previous laws by having a general and wider scope. Four, this Act aims to facilitate effective coordination between the different central and state authorities in environment protection and preservation. As established by existing laws, 5, it aims to confer the central government with wide powers to carry out effective environment protection measures as it sees fit. Six, it aims to lay down a detailed structure that would provide more stability and clarity on the environmental laws of the country. Seven, it also aims to provide deterrent punishment to those who endanger the environment, health and safety. Benefits of environment law. First benefit, protect public health. Second, maintain legacy for future generation. Three, preserves ecological integrity. Four, proper waste management. Detail going on. 1. Protect public health. The Environment Act aims at reducing the emission of carbon dioxide into the environment. This helps maintain clean and fresh air within the atmosphere, which ultimately contributes towards the better health of society. Second, maintain legacy for future generation. The Environment Act in India not only protects the people of the current generation, but it also provides benefits to the people of upcoming generation. The Environment Act makes sure that the current population will serve the future generations. Three, preserve ecological integrity. Another benefit of Environment Act in India is that it empowers communities and protects the environment by taking action against the polluters and strengthening the ecological balance. Four, proper waste management. Waste management helps protect the environment and makes sure that the process of waste management does not interfere with the environment. The law instructs the industries that they must dispose of waste materials according to the set standards and procedures. Thank you. Have a nice day.